Hello, this is Amethyst Lunatari. Welcome to Let's Play Fallout 1, the first. Excited to be playing this for you guys. I've never played this, this game I've never played. Believe it or not, I love RPGs, of course. And I love post-apocalyptic settings, post-apocalyptic stories, movies, books, games, and I've never played any Fallout game, so this is completely blind. I literally have played, I killed a few rats in the first, you know, cavern area right outside the vault, and that is it. Other than that, blind. And I just want to say two quick things. Yeah, other than that, blind. And the second thing is I read all the things, so if that bugs you when people read all the things, and this might not be the LP for you. Now, I'm going to talk a little bit about a few changes and things having to do with the way I'm playing this game and uploading it, and if you want to skip that, I mean, it's stuff you might have a question about, but if you want to skip that, I'm going to put annotations down to, you know, down in the, what do you call it? The description. The video description. Oh, we go automatically into this. Yeah, we've seen that already. Playing this on using Fallout Fixt, which is a mod, 0.81 alpha, which came out like 2 years ago, I think. It's a mod that adds stability to the game, adds descriptions. There are some things missing when you get like a skill increase, things like that. Added in to where the game would not normally tell you things with characters. It fixes things with characters, where they can gain levels or something like that, where they couldn't before, I'm not sure. So things like that, just generally stability, removing bugs overall. So that's cool. As far as this, right, the beginning menu, not the beginning menu, the movie. In the beginning, the intro that I have, I put the Fallout 3 music over that because I tried uploading it, and the Maybe song by Ink Spots, I think it's called, or they're called, that I got an instant, you know, copyright status thing from that. So I can put that video in, but of course it'll be unmonetized. So I did put the Fallout 3 music instead. I've never played Fallout 3, but I have heard some of the music. I've basically just heard the theme songs for Fallout 3 and 4 and New Vegas, and 3 is my favorite, followed by 4. 4 is very hopeful sound, but anyway. Options. Now this is either because of the mod or because of the re-release from Bethesda, that now you have screen settings rather than just preferences. So what I've done here, I am recording this in a really odd resolution, because if you take this off, right, you have all the resolutions, but this scales up. It scales the graphics up to make it bigger. Because what I'm trying to do here is I'm trying to get the footage uploaded in 720. So I'm recording this in 1280 by 960 with the scaling up, so the characters are bigger, the things on the screen, you know, are bigger, rather than making them all tiny and hard for you guys to see and for me to see. So I'm not only increasing the resolution from what it would normally be, but also increasing, you know, we're zooming in the graphics basically. And I'm going to basically be encoding the video in 1280 by 720. So I'm going to be making, I guess, squishing down the vertical just a bit. It's noticeable if you compare, but otherwise to me that it's not that noticeable. And that's basically, I'm trying to get up in a minimum of 720p, because that's considered high definition, and for YouTube's filters, they encode it with a higher like, it goes through their compression filters. It goes to a higher quality compression, basically what it is. So otherwise, I'd play this in like 800 by 600, but then it would be up in 480p, and it would look like crap, because it would be really heavily compressed, more so than this video will be. That's the idea anyway. So that's why I'm playing at 1280 by 960 and then changing the video. So you're always going to have, I can't even see, I don't have access to the black bars on the side. So you're always going to have these black bars, unfortunately. The only other option is for me to stretch the image, and that will look like utter crap. But when you play the game, I'm pretty sure it's stretched out to the whole screen. I'll have to see. And this shows that I'm recording. This is usually not visible. It's visible to me, but usually it doesn't record this. You guys can't see it. For some reason, it's, I guess maybe because I'm playing on a smaller resolution like this. Or this is just an old game with the way the display is. I don't know. So it's there, unfortunately. I did move it from down here up there so you guys can see, you know, and even it would block me for me as well. The messages that go on the screen, how much damage you do, and all that stuff. Combat information and anything else. Descriptions would all go down here. So anyway, we've got 32-bit hertz. I don't know, I would make it 60, but I'm seeing things that you could just leave it at zero. So I don't know. It's by default, it's zero. So I have no idea. And Fog of War enabled. Ignore PC scroll limit, panel scaling. Movies fit the screen. Change sidebar art. Oh, yeah, we'll leave it at this. So I'm going to cancel anyway because I haven't changed anything. That doesn't mean go into that. So as far as game preferences, this is how I have everything. Normal, of course, maximum blood. This is mostly the defaults. I think I changed one thing. Subtitles are on. Item highlight on. I changed this. I changed combat speed to be in the middle. Everything else. I don't think I even changed anything else. Maybe player running was normal. I'm not even sure. So that's that. And what else about this game? That's it. I thought I had a lot more to say, but I do have some things to say when I create the character, so a few things, so. So yeah, new game. Now, I'm not using him. You have options to start with these pre-made characters. Oh yeah, I did read the entire manual last night. So there's that. And there's really no spoilers. I don't think there's anything spoilery in the manual at all. I read the whole thing, so I'm familiar with, you know, the different cursor modes and the, you know, I'm familiar with some skills, traits, things like that. So create character. And I have actually created a character and played up to, you know, killing a few rats. So what they said was anything below 4 is bad. So you don't want that. So I have 5 more points I can put. What I really want to put into is intelligence. Knowledge, wisdom, and the ability to think quickly. A high intelligence is important for any character. Modifies the number of new skill points per level. Dialogue options and many skills. You get more skill points per level just by being more intelligent. Now I want charisma a little as well, because I'm trying to make at least, not overly much, but a somewhat diplomatic character who can, you know, lead her way through, talk her way through things if possible. So I'm not going to go completely nuts on it. Agility is important. Charisma, a combination of appearance and charm. Charisma is important for characters that want to influence people with words. Modifies NPC reactions and barter prices. That's always a good thing. Be able to buy things for maybe a little bit cheaper. Although, from what I read, your reputation will override your charisma anyway. So, the character I'm going to play is basically not a goody two-shoes. Someone who, she tries to do the right thing, but not, you know, she's looking out for herself as well. So to a certain degree, she's not going to take something that's like, you know, would be suicidal for her to do just to help somebody. So I increased charisma and intelligence. I want to increase agility. So as far as I know, they still use this system. Special. It spells out. So this is very similar to, like, you know, Dungeons & Dragons. Actually, if I'm correct, I'm just going to raise agility up 6. If I'm correct, they originally were going to use GURPS, which is generic something role-playing system. And it turned out they lost a license for GURPS and then had to come up with their own system, which is similar anyway. So it's really based on tabletop role-playing. So agility is coordination and ability to move well. A high agility is important for any active character. Modifies action points, armor class, sequence, and many skills. So I have a higher chance of going first in a round. Could help my armor class, possibly. And could have more action points, or things that I have to do will take less action points. So there's that. Strength, raw physical strength. A high strength is good for combat-paced characters and pack rats. Modifies hit points, melee damage, and carry weight. I'm going to probably end up shooting myself, but I don't think I'm going to increase strength at all. So, perception. Oh, that's right. Yeah, I want this, don't I? The ability to see, hear, taste, and notice unusual things. A high perception is important for a sharpshooter. Modifies sequence and ranged combat distance modifiers. I am going to increase this by 1. Endurance. Stamina and physical toughness. A character with a high endurance will survive where others may not. Modifies hit points, poison and radiation resistance, healing rate, and the additional hit points per level. And then I'm probably going to decrease something so I can increase something else. Luck. Finally, fate, karma. An extremely high or low luck will affect the character somehow. Events and situations will be changed by how lucky or unlucky your character is. So you have the higher your luck, basically the higher chance you get to have a critical hit. The lower your luck, you get a critical miss. And I'm not completely sure if it works the same as the perk, but there's a perk which if you make, I forget what the hell it was called, we'll come across it. Actually, it's called Jinxed right here. If you choose Jinxed, I'm not choosing it, by the way. Everyone around you has more critical failures in combat. Yeah, not that. Okay. So, I have one more point in intelligence. Now, do I want to decrease something else to increase something else? I'm going to put luck to 4. As long as it doesn't go underneath 4, I should be okay. I mean, I might still get more critical misses or critical hits on me now that I lowered that one, but hopefully it won't be a significant amount. And I'm torn. Do we want to make perception sequence? Again, you go quicker and around, like agility. Range combat distance modifiers. You know what? I'm going to take... Charisma. Endurance. I really don't want to lower these. This is all pretty important. I mean, yeah, I'd like to be able to talk my way through encounters, but not to the extent that I'm useless in combat, or almost useless. So I think I'm gonna go with this. Wish I had more points, not really happy, but what are you gonna do? Yeah, it won't let me. So traits, as far as traits, you get to choose two traits. So just if you guys want to pause and, you know, look, I'm gonna cycle through them. The ones I'm taking is coming out. Boom. I do like the illustrations. Love them. Now, bloody mess I'm taking. By some strange twist of fate, people around you die very violently. You always see the worst way a person can die. You never saw such violence in vault life, so this may have unforeseen effects on your future actions. So that's on. I guess all of these have a trait. There's a good side and a bad side. So I don't know. I'm not sure what the bad side is to this. I guess maybe you see your friends die violently as well. Now the way I'm going to be playing this game, or at least attempting to, you know, if it's viable for a playthrough, on player death, like my death, of course I'll reload, because otherwise then the let's play is over. But on a, basically on actions that fail, I'm not reloading. Teammates who die, not reloading. You know, it's all just gonna be like real life. Drug reliant, drug resistant. I'm not gonna read all these. Normally I would, but I don't want it. Poor you guys. Dracula. And vampire Fallout Boy. And I'm taking gifted, which I think pays off in the long run. You have more innate abilities. Oh, right, I'll get more from this, won't I? You have more innate abilities and talents than most, so you have not spent as much time honing your skills. Plus one to all your primary statistics, but you start with minus 10% on all skills and receive 5 less skill points per level. Although by boosting my intelligence up helps to offset that a little bit, because you get more skill points just from that. So we're going to be increasing the skill points anyway. I don't know how much there is, but see, everything went up. So now my strength is 6. My perception 7, endurance 6, charisma and intelligence are 8, agility is 7, and luck is 5, still above. So what if I, I'm saying put the luck down to 4 again. Really, I don't want to decrease anything else. This is all way too important. As far as luck, I'm not completely sure. I think it's a chance of something happening. So, I mean, you're not guaranteed that you will succeed at something because you luck, but the percentage of you being able to succeed increases. So I want to increase something else, which is going to be either perception, charisma, or intelligence. Sorry guys, it's just so hard to choose. The ability to see or hear a taste and notice unusual things. When are you going to taste unusual things? Don't tell me, guys. Blind Let's Play, so once again, yeah. No spoilers, please. So, I would like to have everything go as if I don't know what's happening. So my hit points went up by 33 already. I mean, but went up by 3 to equal 33. So, I think I'm going to make intelligence 9. Excellent. Very intelligent. Female. Age. I guess I'll keep that as 25. Now, as far as tag skills, these are your main skills. What I'm going to choose is... I wrote down... Small guns. The use, care, and general knowledge of small firearms, pistols, submachine guns, and rifles. So that's tag skill number 1. And then... lockpick. Skill of opening locks without the proper key. The use of lockpicks or electronic lockpicks will greatly enhance this skill. I'm going to take that. I don't know where... because this is basically when you're starting out, which makes really no sense. Where did she train in small guns inside this vault? Maybe they have a shooting range. I don't know. And I definitely want speech. If I could take another one, I'd take doctor. This is doctor. The healing of major wounds and crippled limbs. Without this skill, it will take a much longer period of time to restore crippled limbs to use. The other one's similar as first aid. General healing skill used to heal small cuts, abrasions, and other minor ills. In game terms, the use of first aid can heal more hit points over time than just rest. So as you go up levels, you can increase these skills anyway, these percentages. But the ones I'm picking will be easier to increase. Basically, when you put skill points in the attack skill, you get double the increase. So, whatever it might be, I'm not choosing that, just... Alright, I want speech. The ability to communicate to a practical and efficient manner. The skill of convincing others that your position is correct. The ability to lie and not get caught. So those are my tag skills. I could tell you right now, my primary, at least at first, skill I'm going to be putting points into that is not a tag skill is going to be doctor. And of course I'm going to have to put twice as many points in this one to increase it as I would these three. And I think we're done. So my armor class is 7. I have 8 action points. Carry weight is 175. Melee damage is 1. Damage resistance 0. Poison resistance 30%. Radiation resistance 12%. Sequence is 14 out of, I don't know what. Healing rate is 2. Critical chance is only 4%. That's okay. When it happens, it'll just be all the more sweeter. It's funny, you can print it. Okay. So done, and I'm gonna go... I keep checking to make sure that everything is good, and it is. So done.
Ha! You're here. Good. We've got a problem. A big one. The controller chip for our water purification system has given up the ghost. Can't make another one, and the process is too complicated for a workaround system. Simply put, we're running out of drinking water.
Uh-uh.
No water, no vault.
Oops.
This is crucial to our survival. And frankly, I think you're the only hope we have.
Why didn't put a name?
You need to go find us another controller chip. We estimate we have 4 to 5 months before the vault runs out of water. We need that chip They marked your map with the location of another vault. Not a bad place to start, I think. Look, just be safe. Okay?
Thrust out into the wide open world. Ooga. So, let's see. I can't. I have to do this over. I literally have to do this over. Okay, I can't believe I forgot. I guess this is partially obscured by the recording thing. Indicator. I forgot to put a name. And... God, you guys can't see it. Hope I typed it right. Hold on a second. Okay, so the name is Allison. Why Allison? Her aim is true. song by Elvis Costello. And also a good friend of mine is named Allison. So that was the first thing I thought. And then I thought of that song. And for the last name, Clark? Oh my god, I can't fit it? Damn. I wanted to put her last name as Clark after one of my favorite authors. What else? Do I have anybody that starts with a... that has a... You know what? Not my favorite author, but... is the only author I could think of off the top of my head that, I've read a lot of books from. And that I really have enjoyed in the past. Stephen King. So there you go. I wanted Clark, but we're Allison King. Done. Okay. Never before have you seen a natural darkness like this one. It almost looks unnatural to you. Your title, Vault Dweller. Now as you go up in an experience, your title changes. Now inventory, let me see. Yeah, I'm only scrolling one thing, but this is one of the things that the Fixt Mod does for you. You can actually scroll through things with the mouse wheel. Lock picks, right? There you go. A set of locksmith tools includes all the necessary picks and tension wrenches to open conventional pick and tumbler locks. It weighs 1 pound. .18mm pistol. So I spelled it right. Allison King. Sorry, 1L. Otherwise I wouldn't be able to fit King either. 10mm pistol. A Colt 6520 10mm auto-loading pistol. Each pull of the trigger will automatically reload the firearm until the magazine is empty. Single shot only using the powerful 10mm round. Minimum strength 3. It has 12 out of 12 shots of 10mm JHP. JHP is crap. I think jacketed hollow point is what it stands for. FMJ is full metal jacket. So I believe this is So we can put this into our item one. I believe that's what it is. So from here, I guess we can't do it from... We can only look at it from there. Okay. If I put it back in here, though... Alright. At some point I was giving it a set of options. Alright. So what do we have here? Mentats. A pillbox of powerful mind-altering drugs increases memory-related functions and speeds other mental processes. Highly addictive. Locks, lockpicks, right? Looked at that. Water flask. A container, also called a canteen, designed for the holding and preservation of water or other liquids. Before the Great War, these were commonly used by hikers, campers, soldiers, and workers in the field. It weighs 2 pounds. Flare. I only have two, right? A flare creates light for a short period of time. The paper is a little worn, but otherwise is in good condition. Twist the top to activate it. It weighs 1 pound. Now, of course, you can get overweight in this game and be unable to move at some point. Stimpak. A Stimpak, or Stimulation Delivery Package, that's what that stands for, is a handheld portable healing unit that consists of a syringe for containing and delivering the medication and a gauge for measuring the status of the Stimpak's contents. When injected, it provides immediate healing of medium wounds and minor tissue damage. No side effects. That's good to know, no side effects. 10 millimeter, I guess jacketed, yeah it is, I was right. Caliber, yeah, jacketed, hollow points. It weighs 1 pound. So, all. There's only three. So we've just loaded our weapon. Wait, I have 72. Oh, because it goes by magazine, I believe. There's probably a quicker way of doing this. Should be full now. Oh, it's just... It is full. Okay. So that's that. Then we've got the Pip-Boy. These are full screen. If I played this on 800 by 600, there would be a little bit of the background back there. But as far as I know, the game is paused no matter what. So get the water chip 150 days late left. That's our primary objective. Somehow, I think this updates. It counts down the days, even though it's written. So I don't know how that works exactly. Status for Vault 13. Find a water chip for the vault. That's that. Auto maps, we don't have anything yet. Archives, overseer briefing. Oh, this will just play the video back, the intro. Well, not the intro video, but the video from after we created our character. So what do we have here? So we had a knife. I can put this... I can't put it in from here. You've seen... Okay. Ten millimeter. Wait. Okay. Now, for inventory, you can hit this, but you can also hit I. So I'm hitting I sometimes. So this will be my... Item 2. A sharp-bladed cutting and stabbing weapon. Minimum strength 2. 1 pound. So that's that. And then these other bullets. Ammunition caliber. 10 millimeter armor piercing. These are armor piercing rounds. I'm not even completely sure, but I think you can use it with this gun as well. So, this, okay, that's O for options. You can do some preferences, but not the screen. And map. Get a nice big map going on here. Oh. High and low. Okay. I'm not sure, it just adds extra details. I guess low might be easier to read. And high adds detail. Apparently you can't zoom in. And this is if you have a motion sensor, which we do not. Maybe we'll find one someday. And your character sheet. Oh, it just says Allison. But it did record Allison King. Now, how long have you been running? We gotta stop now. Should I... I'll kill one thing. Why not? These are my action points. So, I'm gonna kill this rat. I'm not gonna shoot it. How do I switch? Okay. With the middle mouse button, you can switch now. That's another added thing with the option. I mean, with the mod. So where'd this rat go? So I'm not in combat at this time. The rat's here. Oh, it's coming for me. It ran out of action points, I think. Cave rat. Hit for 3 points. I missed. Now, I have 2 of these left. These are my action points. When all these run out, then it's the rat's turn to move. So what I'm going to do... You have an option. You can either stay here, and whatever action points are left will be converted into a bonus to your AC. So I can just stand here with a bonus to my AC, or I can move back, lose that bonus, but then it'll have to use at least some of its action points to get over to me. So I switch the cursor to move. I can't move that far. I mean, sometimes maybe you should just stay there. This is 2. Just tell me 2. So I'm just going to move instead. And now it gets to go. Doesn't it? It didn't move? I don't know. I have all these action points again. Target out of range. It decided not to attack me? Dead. Cave rat was hit for 4 hit points and was killed. You were victorious in combat. You earned 25 experience. Now I guess we will earn 25 experience for any number of these rats, of which there is quite a few. As you can see. I'm not sure if I want to go around killing all of them, and eventually they're going to start running my HP down. But I'm going to end the episode here anyway. Thanks so much for watching, guys, and hope to tune back next time when something actually happens. We will fight more rats and leave this place and see what lies beyond. Thanks again, guys. See you in the next one, and always seek adventure.